Tomorrow's U.S. Open Women's Singles Championship match will be a fairy tale ending no matter who wins. The finalists, 19-year-old Leylah Fernandez of Canada and 18-year-old Emma Raducanu of Great Britain, were barely known just a couple of weeks ago, other than to the closest of followers of the sport. Stacey Allaster is the U.S. Open Tournament Director, the first woman to hold that job, and she's also the former CEO of the Women's Tennis Association. She joins me now from New York. Stacey, who are these two young women, and tell us a little bit about their paths to tomorrow's match the last couple of weeks.
Well, they've become instant stars in these last 2 weeks here in New York at the U.S. Open. Leylah, she had her 19th birthday here. She is from Canada. She's been playing the sport since she was 7 years old. Comes with an athletic father. He was an Ecuadorian soccer player, and her father is her coach. Her mom is a French-Canadian of Filipino descent. I've seen her in the juniors for a few years, and everyone kept talking about her. And it is really incredible. She beat three Grand Slam champions to get to the final of a major here in New York. Incredible. And Emma is a similar story of incredible accomplishments here in 3 weeks. Emma played in the qualifying, where you're trying to earn your way into the main draw. She beat the Olympic gold medalist. She's been playing since she was five. So these two young athletes are lifers, been playing a long time, and they are having their fairy tale moment here on Arthur Ashe.
And Emma, not too long ago, was finishing her high school final exams, what they call the A-levels in Great Britain. As you say, they've developed quite a following in their march to the finals. I mean, what's this going to be like? What do you anticipate tomorrow to be like in the stadium?
Well, we have had, John, the most incredible 2 weeks. Everyone keeps saying this has been the most exciting U.S. Open. The fans just seem to be energized at a different level. Maybe it's because of the pandemic and they're just so happy that they can come to a live sporting event. Or is it what's happened on the court? And it has been unbelievable matches. We've played almost 20 hours more than what we had scheduled on ESPN. So I think it's been the quality of the competition. The fans have been into it, and the fans have helped lift up these two particular, everyone loves the underdog, and each athlete has said that the fans have helped pull them through to this final moment. I cannot wait for tomorrow. It will be electric, and history will be made tomorrow afternoon.
This is a sport where the favorites tend to be the same usual names, tournament after tournament. What does this do for the sport to have these two young women, fresh faces in the finals?
It's an exciting time for our sport. You know, we have been blessed with Serena Williams. We've had her in the draw for almost a quarter of a century. And everyone, as we started this tournament, we don't have Serena. We don't have Roger. We don't have Rafa due to injury. What is the future of tennis? Where are the next champions? And I said at the start of the tournament, what we know for certain, as legacy athletes begin their next chapter in life, the next generation comes along. They stand on their shoulders and they take the sport to the next level. And these two athletes have done it. And it really is then fantastic to bring more youth to our sport. For the USTA, our mission is to recruit new diverse participants to have two athletes of color and of Asian descent is fantastic for the growth of our sport. That's really at the end of the day. They inspire kids to come to a game, and we want everyone to feel welcome to play the sport of tennis.
You mentioned the legacy sports stars of this game. I have to ask you, as we sit here, we will know later tonight whether Novak Djokovic will play in the finals on Sunday for the chance to be the first calendar year Grand Slam winner in 52 years since Rod Laver did it. What would talk a little bit about the significance of that?
The fact that a male hasn't won a Grand Slam since 1969 just shows you how hard physically it is to do. And Novak, alongside of 20 majors, this would be 21, so there's that historic moment. And with the pandemic and the difficulties of performing week in, week out, I think it is even further incredible that tonight and possibly on Sunday, he will be going for that calendar Grand Slam. It's really, really historic. And he's written his own legacy, irrespective of what happens tonight.
Stacey Allaster, Tournament Director of the U.S. Open. You've got a big weekend coming up. Thank you very much.
Thank you, John.